came because I was interested in marine biology and like the whales, but then I got taking some oceanography classes and like I just fell in love with the ocean and all that's in it. It was interesting to learn more about the chemistry behind it, how CO2 reacts in seawater and how it's decreasing the pH through a bunch of reactions.
The ocean takes up a lot of carbon from atmosphere after we're driving a car and heat up the house. And that's a great thing, because otherwise more CO2 will accumulate and more global warming happens. But ocean has to pay the price for it. When CO2 dissolves in the ocean, that reacts with water molecules and produces carbonic acid. That's acidification. The first, most direct impact would be the growth of the marine organisms with calcium carbonate skeletons and shells, such as shellfish, deep sea corals, coccolithophore, which is phytoplankton, pteropod and forams, those are zooplankton. Zooplankton is the food for the fish. So if you lose that zooplankton, the food source is gone for the fish. That means fish population will be affected. And especially critical for the developing countries. Those countries are very poor and depending on the protein source to the seafood, and those people will be affected. So it's a huge socio-economic impact. Canada is a high latitude country, and all ocean is very cold and relatively fresh water. The coast has cold upbraiding. The wind blows in the right way, surface water go offshore to replace the surface water. Deep water comes up. And this water is naturally corrosive to the organisms. But because of the adding aspartic CO2, water gets more corrosive now, and that comes to the surface. West Coast, US and Canada is suffering this corrosive water already. And those water comes into the Arctic, and because of sea ice melt, the water gets less buffered and acidification intensifies. And in the Arctic, already they found corrosive water in the surface layer. And that flows out through Canadian Arctic archipelago and comes to the East Coast and affects the local fisheries. The monitoring of the ocean is the priority. It's important to gather data in climate sciences. So you have to go every year or every season in the same region and understand the change and rate of change.
We're the future generation that's gonna be trying to help protect and save our oceans, and it's very important that we know about them. This is happening and let's try and prevent it.
The speed of change is much, much faster than any geological time scale of last maybe 25 million years. The concern is that the rate of change is so rapid that organisms in the ocean cannot adapt to this speed. There is no sort of uncertainties about ocean acidification. As long as atmospheric CO2 level increases, it's directly reflected to the ocean acidification. We have to develop the method to adapt the change in near future. So we try to find the way to adapt to the new armed high CO2 world.